Latitude and longitude, or lat and long, are words that you've probably heard mentioned in TV shows, books, movies, films. But what exactly do they mean? What are they? And should we even be bothered about them? Keep watching to find out. Hi folks, I'm Craig Taylor, and if you want to improve your bushcraft skills in a simple, no-nonsense fashion, then please consider subscribing to my channel. Cheers. Further to the last video that I recorded in this navigation series, where I talked about coordinates and grid references and what's the difference between them, I wanted to move that conversation on a little further. There are three or four global referencing mapping systems around the world. Three tend to be used globally. One of them is specifically for the poles, the North and South Pole. Now, this series is not going to dive into those four areas in any depth whatsoever, because three of them, I imagine you've never heard of and will probably never come across as well. However, latitude and longitude, as I mentioned at the outset of this video, is a terminology. It is a system that you've probably heard, you've probably come across. Whether you'll ever use it or not, let's talk about at the end of the video. But for now, let's actually talk about what latitude and longitude are, because they are one of a very small handful of mapping systems that are used globally. They are used for aviation, they are used for maritime, and they can also be used on the land for land navigation as well. But again, whether we do or not, I'll address that at the end of the video. To help me convey what latitude and longitude actually is, I have a polystyrene ball and a pocket full of Sharpie markers. So I'm just going to make some annotations on this ball now to help start to understand what latitude and longitude actually mean and what they are. My white, untarnished polystyrene ball is no more. I've made some annotations, I've made some markings on it. Let me explain what they mean. The red orange line that you can see now, hastily drawn, is the equator. At the top of the Earth is the North Pole. At the bottom of the Earth is the South Pole. And I've also placed a green triangle there representing Great Britain. Now, I'm not discounting every other country and landmass in the world, I promise you. But I've placed Great Britain on there for a very good reason, which will become apparent as this video unfolds. So for now, equator, North Pole, South Pole. Where have I gone? There I am, Great Britain. Hope that makes sense so far. Back to my model. There's the North Pole. There's the South Pole. Let me put my fingers there. Roughly in the centre of your screen, now you'll be able to pick up the equator. In fact, let me write the letter E on there, because I've rather foolishly used the same colour. So there's the equator, there's North Pole, there's the South Pole. I've now drawn on lines of latitude, or lat, as they are sometimes referred to. They run east to west. Lines of latitude are parallel to one another, unlike my terrible drawing on here. They're used to indicate how far north or south you are. Now, you can see the equator there, so you can see all of those lines that are running above the equator line are heading towards north, and all the lines that are below it are heading towards south. So they're used to indicate how north or south you are from a known point, the known point being the equator. The furthest north you can get from the equator in latitude is 90 degrees, and, funny old thing, the furthest south that you can get from the equator is 90 degrees south. 90 degrees north, 90 degrees south. Hopefully that's making sense so far. On my model, these lines are a couple of millimetres, a couple of centimetres, an inch or so from one another. In the real world, literally on the world's surface, they're about 110 kilometres apart from one another. So that's latitude. They run north and south of the equator. The North Pole is 90 degrees north. The South Pole is 90 degrees south. They're about 110 kilometres from one another. Clearly, if they're 110 k's from one another, there's a damn sight more lines of latitude than my diagram, my model, actually shows. But that's a breakdown on latitude. Let's now move on to lines of longitude. If we think that lines of latitude that we've just looked at run horizontally, lines of longitude run vertically. They start and finish at the north slash south poles and are measured from true north. You may be thinking, why is that? What is that green triangle for? What is he wanting to represent Great Britain for? Well, it's because when these are numbered, they have to start from somewhere. Same as lines of latitude start from the equator, a fixed point. In terms of longitude, they also need a fixed point to be measured east and west from. And that fixed point actually runs through Greenwich, the Greenwich Meridian line. And that line literally runs from the North Pole through to the South Pole, through the Greenwich part of the UK. That line continues, and quite ironically, quite bizarrely, a few hundred metres probably behind me is where the Greenwich Meridian line actually leaves the UK, bisects the UK coastline and heads further south towards France. I pretty much live almost on the Greenwich Meridian line where I am. But I digress, let's get back to this. So there we can see the 0 degree longitude line starts, finishes, converges at the poles, runs through the UK, specifically in the area of Greenwich, hence the Greenwich Meridian line. There are other map datum points, believe it or not. I believe there's one in France, and I think there are some others as well. If I can find out what they are, I will drop them into the notes below this YouTube video. So there's not just the one, quite confusingly, map datum point from which lat and long are measured, but primarily the one that is kind of globally recognised is the one that I'm referring to in this video here today. Let me draw a few more lines onto this so that you get the same representation, same idea how lines of longitude work as you have with the lines of latitude. Just give me a second. I've added a few more on there now, and hopefully, perhaps if you've ever looked at a globe closely and you've noticed these lines running horizontal and vertically, it's starting to very loosely resemble that. Let me find the UK. There it is there. Now, in the same way that when we were talking about latitude from the equator, 90 degrees north or 90 degrees south, being the North Pole or South Pole, the same principle applies with your longitudinal measurements. So there is the UK there, and I'm just going to tilt this ever so slightly so you can start to see the other side of the Earth from the UK. You'll notice that the UK is sat on that Greenwich Meridian line. Longitude is measured not north and south like latitude is, but east and west. And you can either be, the furthest you can be, is 180 degrees east or west, in other words, the other side of the world, literally, from the Greenwich Meridian line. So you're either 1 degree east or 1 degree west, 90 degrees east, 90 degree west, 120 degrees east, 120 degrees west, you get the idea. Hopefully now you're starting to be able to see that if we can tell people geographically how many degrees north or south we are and how many degrees east or west we are, we can start to vector in and start to build up an idea of a latitude and longitude coordinate. Now, the Earth's a big old place, right? It's probably the biggest place you and I are ever going to go to. It's a big place. So just breaking things down into degrees, 90 degrees north or south, 180 degrees east or west, it isn't enough. It's still a huge area. So every degree has 60 minutes within it. Every minute has 60 seconds within it. Now that's quite easy to remember because it's the same denomination of quantity that we use to tell the time. 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour. Except this time it's 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in a degree. So we just substitute the hour out. It's fairly simple to remember. Now I'm not going to attempt to mark on this individual 60 minute and then 60 second increments. It would become an even bigger mess than what it already is. But just to give you that concept that yes, we're talking about 90 degrees or 180 degrees north or south or east or west, but even that's not good enough. It needs to be smaller and smaller and smaller than that, which is where latitude and longitude, if you ever look at latitude and longitude references, I encourage you to go and Google some now, you will see that they are long strings of numbers, two long strings of numbers to be precise, with north and south and east and west determining how far up or down or how far around we are going from the equator or usually the Greenwich Meridian line. So that's a really basic layperson's introduction to latitude and longitude, what they are and what they mean. The bigger question though is this: should you be bothered? Let's answer that killer question. Should you be bothered? Firstly, let me say latitude and longitude, they're bona fide coordinate systems, okay? They've been around for a very, 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 very long time. They're not going anywhere. Aviation, maritime, some land navigators use them. I don't, though, and I want to explain to you why I don't, because I don't want you to think that if Craig doesn't use them, then they're crap. I want you to be informed as to why I don't use them and see if my reasons and my variables fit with yours. Firstly, from a practical perspective, if you look at an ordnance survey map, if you've got one, dig it out, go and take a look. Look around the edges if you haven't cut it down, if you have, look around the edges, look closely, look carefully around the edges. You will see some reference to latitude and longitude around the edges. Look onto the map itself, the detail of the map, the bit you'd usually be using, try and find some reference then. Good luck. What you will find reference on the map is the mapping coordinate system that is being used for that map, other than latitude and longitude. So from a sheer accessibility perspective, it's bloody hard to find the latitude and longitude references on most land maps. Not all, but most land maps it's hard to find. If you can find them, they don't transfer onto the actual map. They're just around the edges. I've done several training exercises over the years using lat and long, and you end up having to get pen and paper out and mark increments, and it all just becomes a little bit theoretical, to be perfectly honest, because the likelihood of being able to do that out here in the field is not nil, but it's drastically reduced, let me tell you. So there's one reason why I just don't choose to use latitude and longitude. It's an accessibility perspective. And the second reason, second/third reason, I suppose, wrap it up in one, is it's bloody tricky. It's finicky. It's incredibly open to human error. Taking any grid referencing system or mapping coordinate system is open to human error, don't get me wrong. But you're talking 60 seconds within a minute, 60 minutes within a degree, 180 degrees or 90 degrees, east or west or north or south. There's a lot going on, okay? You don't want to make life harder for yourself. And the final reason why I don't use them is I've never used them. I've never really had to use them. I've used them in training exercises. I've used them on theoretical desktop exercises. I've used them myself. I think the last time I used them was around 2002 or 3 in Oman in the Middle East to put together a navigation exercise for some Royal Marines that I was attached to at the time. Oh, look at the way the sun's shining. Everything's dark, but me, it's like I'm some sort of angelic being. that's why. The practical reason is I have navigated for donkey's years with a relatively good degree of accuracy, and I've never needed to use latitude and longitude. So why overcomplicate things? Don't take my word for it. Dig into your maps. Dig into the subject of latitude and longitude. See if it fits with what you do. If you fly a light aircraft, if you sail, then by God, it's going to fit with what you want to do, and it's probably the de facto for that particular pastime or hobby. But if you're more land-based like me and use more accessible land-based maps, it does tend to become more of a theoretical underpinning piece of knowledge, which is good to have, always useful in pub quizzes, but practically out on the ground, you're probably never going to need to use it. But I wanted to put this video together because it's such a well-known coordinate system. Didn't want to skim over it and not give it the attention and airtime that it very rightly deserves. But you be the judge of it. I mentioned earlier on in the video, a previous video I've done on coordinates and grid references and what's the difference between them. If you've not seen that yet, check that out. It's going to appear in this top corner of the screen here. Check that out because it really is setting up this series I'm creating on grid references. Thank you for taking the time to watch. And if you're not yet a subscriber, you know what to do by now. Take care, folks, and stay safe.